Here is my start file, basic reports. You can download the exercise file and follow along by clicking on the link below this video. In this tutorial, I want to talk about creating reports in an Access database. In this database, if you look at the navigation pane, you see the different objects. So I can recognize from the icon that this is the group of tables and it has the label tables. Then I have queries, it has a different icon, and then I have forms, and then I have reports. Each one of these database elements has a different icon. If you look at the ribbon, you see the default tabs of the ribbon, the home, the create, the external data, and the database tools. But look what happens to the ribbon when I open a report. I'm going to double click on report product. And when I double click on that, it opens in print preview. Access knows that a report is either used to be displayed on screen or to be printed and get a hard copy. And that's why it replaces the default tabs of the ribbon with the print preview tab. And on the print preview tab, you have all the functionality and tools for printing the report. You can adjust the size, you can adjust the margins, or you can change the orientation from portrait to landscape and so many other functionality for printing the report. But the question is, how to create a report? We have different ways of creating a report, and at the basic level, they are pretty close to creating a form. Whatever you want to create, you have to go to the Create tab of the ribbon. So if I click on the Create tab, then in the reports group, I have a functionality that maps almost at the basic level to the functionality of creating a form. So I have the report tool, which matches the form tool for creating a form. I have the report wizard, which matches the form wizard for creating a form. And then we have the report design. Let's see how we create a report by using each one of these techniques. First of all, I want to start creating a report using the simplest technique. So what if I select, let's say, table order, that's the source object, and based on table order, I want to create a report by using the report tool. So one single click, when I click on the report tool, then a report will be created. The report opens in layout view, and because I didn't have any options when creating this report, then it includes all the fields from the source table. It even inherits the name of the source table. When a report opens in layout view, you can make simple modifications to the design. Let's say you can change the field width by hovering over the border of this orange frame, and then when I drag, I'm changing the field width. I can delete this icon, which means it's a report. I select it and then hit delete. I can edit the report label by triple clicking, and then I can delete this extra TBL, which is useful for the developer, but not user-friendly for the regular user. I created my very first report using the report tool. Now I'm going to close it without saving, and I want to create a report by using the report wizard. Then I go to the Create tab one more time, and on the Create tab in the Reports group, I click on Report Wizard. The first thing I need to do is to select the source table, the source object. It could be a table, it could be a query, and I'll be selecting Table Retailer as a source object. Now I see in the lower left box, I see the different fields coming from this table. I need to select some of them. Let's say retailer name, and I click on the right pointing arrow. And then I want the city, the region, and I want the first name and last name. And then I want the phone number. These are the fields that I want to see in my report. Note that many clients are sharing the same region. I do have many clients in California, I do have many clients in New York, and so on. So I'm going to click on Next, and in the next step it asks me, would you like to group by any one of these fields? So what if I select Region? Keep an eye on what will happen in the upper part of this window. So when I click on Next, then the region appears in blue at the top, that's a grouping level. And then when I click Next, here it asks me, would you like to sort? Well, it could be a good practice to sort by one of the fields. I'll be sorting by retailer name. And then when I hit Next, here it asks me about the layout. I can select any one of the layouts, and here is a preview box to see how it looks like. I can change the orientation if I wish. I'm going to change it to landscape. And I make sure that I adjust the field width so that all the fields fit on one page by checking this box. And then when I click on Next, I would have created my report. I can name it clients, and then I hit finish. The report opens, and this is how it looks like. This is the grouping level. I created a grouping by region, so I have my clients grouped by each region. I see lots of spaces between the fields, and the last field, the phone number, is truncated. And to fix all these issues, I have to switch to design view. We'll be creating an entire report in design view. Let's close this report and let's create a report using the last method, which is creating the report and having full control by going to design view. So this time I go to the create tab and here I click on report design. I see three sections of my report and I see a field list. I can clone the field list if I want. I can bring it back later. A report consists basically of five different sections. What I see right now are three sections only: a detailed section, which is the main section, a page header, and a page footer. I'll be adding a report header and a report footer as well. So if I right-click in the detailed section, I can select report header and footer. So now I have five sections. Look at the different sections. I'm going to reduce the height of this one. Now I can see all the sections in one screen. So I have a report header, I have a page header, a detailed section, a page footer, and a report footer. The report header appears once at the beginning of the report, while the page header, whatever you put in the page header, will appear at the top of each printed page. The same applies to the page footer and the report footer. The report footer appears once at the end of the report, while the page footer appears at the bottom of each printed page. So what do you put in a page footer? I can put the page numbers because they will appear at the bottom of each printed page. What do you put in the report footer? In a report footer, I can put the total of an invoice, the sales tax, the subtotal, and this kind of information that should appear at the end of my report, and it should appear once. Now let's go to the report header and customize it. I'm creating an order details report. So I select this horizontal bar saying page header. I drag it a little bit down to make some room for the report header, and I would like to add a label control. On the ribbon, I have four tabs. I have the design tab, I have the arrange tab, I have the format tab, and the page setup. On the design tab, I have a group for controls. The type of control that I want to create, this is called a label control. So if I click on this capital A and small a, the label control, look at my mouse pointer, it becomes a plus sign with a capital A. When I click and drag, it creates a label box and I'll be typing order details. I click outside and then I click on the border and then I go to the format tab and apply some basic formatting. So I can bump up my font, let's say to 26. I can change the font, I can bold it, I can change the font color, all kind of formatting as you do in Microsoft Word. I can even center it right and left. So I created my label. Now I would like to add controls from the source table. And to add controls, I have to go to the design tab. And on the design tab, I have to bring the pane here to the right called the field list. So I click on add existing fields. The field list opens, but I don't see any tables until I click on show all tables. When you click on this, you see the different tables coming from the database and they match the table that you see in the navigation pane on the opposite side. And because I want to create a report for the order details, then I'll be using fields from table order item. When I click on the plus sign to the left side of the table name, then it expands and I see the different fields. In this report, I'm going to use the item order ID, so I double click on that, and then I'm going to use the next field, the product ID, and then I select the item quantity, and let's say the unit price. These are all the fields I want. Remember, this is the report, and if you leave all this space above and below, that will be a real abuse of the paper, because it will consume a lot of paper unnecessarily. At the same time, if you look at the left side, these labels will keep repeating for each record. Let me show you what I mean by switching to report view. So if I click on report view in the lower right corner, then in this case, this is the report view. And you can see in report view, there is a lot of space left unnecessarily above and below each record. And to go to the next record, I have to keep scrolling down. I want to get rid of all this space, and at the same time, I want to get rid of this shaded color alternating row color. Let's see how we do that in Design View. I switch one more time to Design View. I create a selection rectangle to include all the fields, and I drag them up in the Details section. I reduce the height of the Details section by dragging this horizontal bar up as well. Now let's see our report. After this little change, I go to Report View, and now I can see that I don't have any space. I'm going to remove this alternating color, and I want to change the appearance of my report. So I go to Design View one more time. I go to the Format tab, and on the Format tab, the alternating color appears in the Details section. So I have to select the Details section, and then here I say, for the alternate row color, I don't want to see this, so I want no color. Now if I switch back to Report View, it reflects the changes that I have done. Remember, all the information is in the Details section, and anything you put in the Details section keeps repeating for each record in the source table. So if you have in the source table 100 records, then you will see order ID, product, quantity, price paid, the same number of time. If you have 1,000,000 records, then you will see these labels 1,000,000 times. What if I want to see them only once and have them appear here at the top as label, and they appear once at the top of each printed page? Let's see how we do that. I'm going to switch to Design View one more time, and when I switch to Design View, all what I'm going to do is to move these labels to another section. And I start with the price paid. I'm going to cut and paste in the page header. I'm changing the appearance of my report. So I hit Ctrl X to cut, and then I go here to this section, Ctrl V, and I drag to the right. I'll be doing the same exact thing for each one of the labels. I moved all the labels to the page header, and anything you put in the page header will appear once at the top of each printed page. Now I want to adjust the value boxes below their corresponding labels. I adjusted the value box for each field below the corresponding label by dragging. And the final thing I want to do to finalize this report is to reduce the height of the Details section. And now we'll switch to Report View and see how this report has changed completely. I click on Report View, and now look at this report. It looks totally different. Should you wish to get rid of this outline around each one of the boxes, then you go one more time to the Design View, select the value boxes. I select the first one, I click on the second and the third while pressing Shift, and then I go to the Format tab. Each one of these is a shape. I don't want to shape outline. I want to set it to transparent, and that will fix the issue. Now if I switch to Report View, this is the final appearance of my report. And remember, anything you put in the Details section keeps repeating for each record, while if you move it to the page header, it appears only once, and this is what we did for these labels. In this tutorial, we explored reports, and we learned different methods for creating reports, either by using the Report tool, or by using the Report Wizard, or by creating the report in Design View, where we have a lot more options to control the appearance of our report.